Faces OFTHE News, August 18, 2019. Presida Ruiza Acosta is seen sandbagging fake PS Crusader and Public Attorney's Office, PAO. Chief Presida Ruiza Acosta is facing a mutiny. In an anonymous manifesto, several ranking lawyers from the PAO's central office exposed Acosta's alleged entrenched and systemic corruption. The lawyers, who said they have knowledge of the goings-on in Acosta's office, says she has placed in the PAO's finance department royal certified public accountants who helped her funnel the agency's budget for her personal use. She is also allegedly an ambulance chaser, forcing the families of children who have died after reportedly receiving the DEM vaccine to get the PAO's services. She also allegedly diverted the office's budget to buying tarpaulin, tea-hyphen shirts and coffins used in these families' rallies against officials involved in the Benghazia issue. Acosta, known for her tricks to call attention to her crusade, vehemently denied the group's allegations. Gretchen Diaz, a transgender woman, landed in the news after she was barred from using the women's restroom in a Cuban city mall, despite the city's gender fair equality ordinance. Diaz asserted her right to the facility and posted on social media the video of her altercation with the cleaner. After being dragged to and detained at the mall's security office, she was brought to a police precinct where she was handcuffed and arrested. Members of the Plus community, concerned netizens, the comrades, Geraldine Roman and Senator Lisa Hontegros quickly made representations on Diaz's behalf and had her released from police custody. Despite the mall management's apology, the incident brought into focus instances of discrimination based on gender and how the city ordinance still needs to be disseminated for proper implementation. The issue isn't just about what restroom to use, Diaz said. This can happen to anyone. Monique Wilson has always shuttled between art and activism. As an actress, she was acclaimed for her roles in controversial plays like The Vagina Monologues, Angels in America and My Name is Rachel Corey. She won a Urian for La Rosa Vaga and an Ailey for Cabaret. But in recent years, acting had to take a backseat after the former Pound awardee was cast to lead Vermillion Rising, a global campaign founded by Eve Ensler to end rape and violence against women. On her return to acting last week, the former Miss Saigon star fused her two passions by playing a male character. Jason Castro walked to the TNT bench with his head bowed and defiantly clapped his hands as if in mock praise of his last foul. He would have loved another shot at this conference. He and his team had whisked through the elimination round with 3-point shooting ease and became the number one team of the PBA Commissioner's Cup. But basketball gods don't hand out redos. And as he reached the sideline, it was San Miguel Beer that started celebrating. The Beermen won a second straight championship and Castro watched from the bench as confetti rained down the Coliseum in a celebration he should have been a part of. He has been named best player of the conference, but his dreams of a title will have to start from zero again. It's a learning experience, he told reporters. Even for a veteran of his stature, there is so much more to build on from this defeat as he looks forward to the next tournament. Ronald De La Rosa in what many see as a witch hunt or red baiting, Senator Ronald Beto De La Rosa, who chairs the Senate Committee on Public Order, presented in a hearing several mothers weeping over their missing children, who were allegedly kidnapped by left-leaning youth organizations. He then said into the need for the police and military to be allowed entry into state colleges and universities to supposedly compete with militant groups in recruiting students. Days later, the missing students surfaced to belie their mother's claims about being kidnapped or brainwashed by leftist groups, and suggested how the police might have manipulated their parents instead. This did not stop De La Rosa from calling for the firing of teachers who encourage students to learn beyond the classroom by attending rallies. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe.